Splatter paint nails. Hey guys, what's up? It's Lily. So today I'm going to do this splatter paint nail tutorial. You guys wanted me to do it, so I'm doing it today. This is my first nail tutorial ever. It's really eye-catching, really great for parties, school, whatever you want. It's just really fun and easy. So if you want to learn how to do this look, keep watching.
Okay, so here I have the things you're going to need. You're going to need white nail polish. Oh, sorry about the stuff back there. That's just on my counter. But I just have the Ulta white nail polish. It's the Salon Formula Nail Lacquer. In Snow White. So that's my white nail polish. I have these colors. I'm not going to be using green. But you can substitute blue for green if you would like. But I'm just going to be using blue. So this is just Ruby Kisses nail polish. It's just a really lime green. I don't know what it's called. This is the Sally Hansen Extreme Wear. This is the yellow one in Mellow Yellow. So yeah, it's in Mellow Yellow. I would really recommend these, the Wet n Wild nail color. I don't know what this is, just a red. Next I have the Sally Hansen again. Extreme Wear nail color. I actually like the blue better than the yellow. This is in Blew Me Away. It's like my favorite name for a nail polish ever. This is by far my favorite color I'm going to be using today. It's the Simple Colors Professional Nail Polish in Summer Peach. I love this color. It's a really good color for summer. Next are toothpicks. I just have normal toothpicks. Optional cuticle butter or cuticle cream. And then, yeah, or optional a nail hardener. So that's all the stuff you're going to be needing, and let's get started with the tutorial.
Before this, I just added a nail hardener. You can also add a top coat just to clear nail polish to protect your natural nails.
Okay, so next I just went ahead and added my Burt's Bees Lemon Butter Cuticle Cream. I love this cuticle cream so much. I've used so much of it, if you guys can tell. All I do is just put a little teeny dot on my nail, and then or on my cuticle, and then rub it in. Also, I use my cuticle massage cream, Sally Hansen, with Epcot oil. This is just a cuticle cream as well. I've used so much of this, too. I like both of them. And it smells really good. Okay, so next, when the white is dry, you're going to want to have toothpicks, and you can either use a paper towel or a separate note card to glob the nail polish onto. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to have a separate toothpick for each color because otherwise it would get all weird and lumpy. So the first color I'm going to be using is the red polish. So what you're going to want to do is you're going to want to take the red nail polish, shake it, open it up. So you're going to want to take the tip and just have glob a teeny, teeny little dot onto the red or onto the nail, like so. Then you're just going to flick it out with the toothpick. So, I hope you guys can see this. But all I'm going to do is I'm going to flick the design outward into three shapes like this. On either side, you're just going to flick it out just like that, kind of like a star. Then you want to take from the center and add some dots randomly onto the nail. What I like to do is I like to add a glob of red nail polish onto my paper and then dot it. Just makes it easier. And then you're going to do this to each nail. Okay, so once you have all the red splatters on your nails, it should look something like this. Now I'm going to use the orange, which is the Sinful Colors nail polish in Summer Peach. So it's a really neon orange. I don't know if it's coming up washed on camera, but... Sorry, I have a cold, but it's a really, really neon orange. Neon orange, sorry. So, you're basically going to do the same thing. It doesn't matter if it goes over one of the red dots or whatever color you had. As you can see, the orange nail polish, this happened to me last time I did this, is very blotty, or it makes a really, really big ball. So what you're going to do is you're going to take your toothpick, flick up from it, and then wipe it off on the paper towel or on a note card. So as you can see, it's not as big. Then you just want to flick it out the same way you did with the other ones. Just like that. Then you're going to want to take the note card and apply a little bit of red nail polish to it. Dip your toothpick in and create dots around. So when I'm done with doing the orange nail splatter, I'll get back to you. Okay, so as you can see, the orange paint splatter is on. I think you guys get the hang of it now. So basically, all I'm doing is I'm just adding a paint splatter to my nail. So now I'm going to do blue. I already shook it up, and all you just do is add a dot to your nail. So all you do is add a dot. Flick it outward, then make some dots on the nail. So I think you guys get the hang of it. So I'm going to go ahead and do all my hands with the blue, and then I'm going to do the yellow, and then when I'm done with that, I'll get back to you. So now I've applied the blue paint splatter, and now I'm just going to apply the yellow paint splatter and do the same method. So I did the yellow paint splatter, and when you're done, it should look something like this. It looks really cool. I think it's really nice for, like, parties or whatever. And if you have some on your hands or around, you can just take some nail polish remover. You can put some on a little piece of paper towel or a cotton swab or something. I'm just going to use a little piece of paper towel to get the nail polish off my hands. If you guys can see, it got a little on my hands when I was using the toothpick. So when you're done, you're going to want to add a base coat to keep it from chipping and lasting as long as possible. I have this Maybelline Express Finish 50 second nail color. Your nail polish should dry flat, so don't worry if you add kind of like a lump on your nails. It should dry flat. Again, this is really good for parties or school or whatever. You can wear it anywhere you want to.
So this is the finished nail look. I really like this nail look. It's really eye-catching. It's great for anywhere you're going. I'd recommend wearing this to a party, but it's really fun for school, too. Sorry if you couldn't see me doing some of the splatter. It's my first nail tutorial, so it might not have been as good as some of the ones I'm going to do in the future, but I hope you like this. Comment down below if you like this, and tell me if you want more nail tutorials. So thank you guys for watching. Bye. Thanks for watching Living for Fashion. Don't forget to follow me on Twitter at twitter.com/livingforfashion. Comment, rate, request, and subscribe. Bye.